Hello beautiful people, welcome back again to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking to watch this video. I really appreciate it. In case you're new to this channel, you see my beautiful face for the very first time. Hello, my name is Rejoice. Please subscribe to this channel, turn on the post notification bell to all, like this video, share with friends and family, and leave your comments at the comment section after watching this video. Guys, in today's video, I'll be talking about things you need to know about Abuja. Yes, I'll be speaking based on my view. I've been observing this city for a period of time now, and from my observation, from my experience, I can still tell you things that you really need to know about Abuja, which no one will tell you. Yeah, like no one will tell you about these things. Like, okay, you might find some on social media, but there are some core things that no one will ever tell you about Abuja. The number one thing I would like to talk about is Abuja has a whole lot of beggars. Like, there are many beggars in Abuja. When I'm talking about beggars, you know, we have different kind of beggars. We have the, you know, classic beggars, we have the normal beggars, and we have the poor beggars. Like, Abuja is with a whole lot of beggars. When I mean beggars now, I'm talking about the poor beggars. Like, every single time that I go out, I always find beggars in every area. At some point, okay, there was a time I was in Garimpa, and Garimpa is one of the biggest and largest housing estates in Africa. I was not expecting to see beggars around that area, because houses over there, you know, are houses that are very, very expensive. The kind of people that are living in that area are people that, you know, have money, like people that are wealthy. They are the kind of people that lives in that particular estate. But I need to tell you, the very first day I went there, I saw a lot of beggars, and I was like, wow, like, how can this estate, how would they have? I was expecting to see classic beggars, not the poor beggars, you understand? So nobody will ever tell you that every corner in this city, they have beggars. Like, even if you go to a very classic restaurant, probably you might not find them inside the restaurant, but maybe when you are going out, you're about to step out of the compound or something, you will just find them around. And another thing is, inside the traffic, you will always find beggars. There are some areas, yeah, that I was not even expecting to see beggars at all. So that, no one will ever tell you that there are a whole lot of beggars in this city. And another thing about these beggars is they have the younger ones, they have the older ones, and they have, like, they have children and the adults, which it saddens my heart so much that how can people be giving birth and, you know, allow their children to be on the streets begging for food to eat, begging for money. And at some point, I talked about this to my friend, and my friend was like, okay, let me explain it to you, that most of these children, they have godfathers that after, you know, begging the whole day, they will deliver the money to the godfather, and the godfather will give them their share, which saddens my heart so much. I see a whole lot of, you know, mothers on the streets begging for what to eat. It's not as if they are disabled or something. They have their two eyes, they have their legs, they have their hands. Everything about them is complete, but they chose not to work. They chose to be a beggar, which saddens my heart so much. And for the children, at some point, I keep asking, is it that these children don't go to school at all? And they're like, no, they don't go to school. And I was like, no, this shouldn't be it at all. Like, these children should be in school. Like, a whole lot of children on the street. Like, it's not a public, like, a market space or something. Like, even in estates, you'll find them all around. So there are so many beggars in Abuja. That is the number one thing that I would like to share. And let me say this about those beggars: some of them are aggressive. No one will tell you this. Like, there was a day I was putting on a very open clothes, like it was tube, it was armless, every part of my body here you can see it, and it was a tube. And, you know, we're going somewhere, and my friend was like, see, the reason why this young children will not harass you is because we wind up, you know, in the car. That assuming the glasses is not wind up, and these children comes to you, ask for money, and you fail to give them, they will harass you. Like, they will try and point at you. And I was like, are you serious? Since that time, I'm always scared of those beggars, which gave me a mixed feeling that I hope this country is not providing the future Boko Harams. I'm sorry, I just have to say the way it is, that, like, that was what came to my mind, that if at this tender age, they know how to harass people, they know how to, you know, beg for money, what is the future of this country? Because the children are the future of this country. That is number one thing I would like to share about Abuja. Number two thing that I would like to share that you need to know about Abuja is Abuja is home for the rich and the poor. Yes, like what we see on the TV, what everyone, for people that have not been to Abuja, everybody knows that Abuja belongs to the rich. Like, Yeah, but I still need to tell you that Abuja is for the rich and the poor. There are so many areas in Abuja that, you know, they are more or less like slum. Yes, like you can't even believe that you are in Abuja. I remember there was a particular video that I shot about Almat Farm. Yeah, when we were going to that place, at some point I was asking my friend that, please, are you sure that we are still in Abuja? Because of the area, Kuje area that we went to, it looks like slum and it looks like a very poor area. Like, it's actually a very poor area. Like, now let's talk about the rich. Now the rich are, you know, have a very good life in this city, while the poor have a very bad life in this city. There are some places that if you go to in this Abuja, you won't even believe that it's Abuja any longer. You'll feel like, no, I'm not in Abuja. Meanwhile, you are still in Abuja. There are so many places which I would have loved to talk about, like places like that looks like slum, but I don't want to share that. So that is one thing that some people might not tell you. You might feel like Abuja is only for the rich, but I'm telling you that Abuja is for the rich and the poor. Another thing that I would like you to know about Abuja is, in the next 30 to 50 years, Abuja will be an home for the rich alone. How do I mean? Let's talk about the housing. Housing in Abuja is extremely cost, like it's very, very expensive. There are some areas that, you know, if you go there, you feel like, oh, housing in this area should not be expensive. But housing in such area are still very expensive. If you want to live a very good life in Abuja, I need to tell you, housing is very, very expensive. Like, when I had the amount my friends paid yearly, I was like, no. Like, this particular money is money you can easily use to get a land. And, like, if you add, like, times two of it, I can tell you, in 3 years, you will have your own house, probably in places like Ibadan, Kwara State, Osun State, and some other states. So that's why I said, in the next 30 to 50 years, Abuja will be an home just for the rich. Yeah, because housing here is extremely cost. But I will not lie, the housing are, you know, they really worth it, because the way they build houses here is top-notch. Yeah, when I mean top-notch, it's actually top-notch. Okay, now let's talk about transportation in Abuja. If I'm to talk about public transportation in Abuja, I would say it's not cheap, but it is affordable. Yeah, how do I mean? Like, a normal car will take three at the back and one at the front, and there's some that, you know, they are always like, okay, let's go against the rules and regulation of public transportations wherever in Abuja. So they will pick two. They will two people might, but most of their public transport here is only one person at the front and three people at the back, which I feel like it is affordable, but it is not cheap. Yeah, that is it. Now let's talk about you taking boat, Uber, or whatever other transportation it is. Guys, it is kind of expensive. Yes, it is. I remember the very first time I took boat in this city. It was not something extremely far, like it was not a place that was really, really far, but the price was high, and I was like, no. Okay, now I feel like there are some things about this transportation. Like, if you are taking the regular public transport, if you don't mind sharing the car with anyone, yeah, it's affordable. But if you want to just live that, you know, very good life whereby you are the only one inside the car, the AC, you're enjoying yourself, you can do anything, it is expensive. Like, if you have to take boat or Uber, it is expensive. Now let's talk about Keke Napep and bike. If you are taking those stuffs, they are not expensive as well. So that is all about transportation when it comes to Abuja living. Another thing that I would like to share with you about Abuja living that people might not tell you is clothes and shoes. Like, they are in some areas they are expensive, while some areas are not expensive. How do I mean? I'm the type that enjoy window shopping a lot. I remember there was a day I was sitting at a restaurant. Let's build it to that restaurant. There's a shop where they sell clothes and some beautiful stuff like shoe bag and everything, and I literally entered, you know, just to feed my eyes and see if probably I can buy stuff there. So immediately I entered, I was seeing gang of like 9,000 naira. I saw gang of like 15,000 naira. Like, that gang of like 9,000 naira, for me, it doesn't worth it. The gang of like 15,000 to 25,000 naira that I saw that day, I can't say it doesn't worth it, but I feel like it's still expensive. Like, a single gown for like 25,000 naira in that kind of area, for me, it is expensive. And if I'm to talk about the other side of Abuja, well, okay, there was a day I went to shoot a video at Dutse, and guys, I saw people that, you know, people that sells clothes with the wheelbarrow. And I saw a whole lot of different clothes, like very beautiful clothes. And that day, it wasn't as if I wanted to buy clothes, but I was just like, I want to have an idea of how much they sell these stuffs. And I noticed that it was affordable. And I can even say those clothes are very, very cheap. These are not UK used clothes. They are absolutely new clothes that normally, if you are to take them inside the boutique, the clothes that they want to sell for me at 1,200 naira, 1,500 naira, if those clothes enters into boutique, they will be selling them nothing less than 9,000, 10,000, 12,000 naira. So when it comes to clothing, shoes, bags in Abuja, it depends on where you want to get it. It depends on what you want. But if you don't mind getting on wheelbarrow, it's good for you. It is affordable. But if you want boutique standard, oh my God. My God got a shoe and the shoe was around 35 to 45,000 naira. And I was like, wow. Just one shoe. It depends on where you are getting whatsoever you want. So I cannot really say it is expensive and I cannot say it is affordable. It depends on where you are getting your stuffs from. Now let's talk about food in Abuja. I would say food in Abuja are expensive. Yes. How do I mean? I was able to shoot a video about, you know, what a thousand naira feed you in Abuja for a whole day, which I have to go to a particular area just to achieve that kind of video. But if I'm to use a regular restaurant to judge this, I will tell you that food in Abuja are kind of expensive, especially when it comes to cooked food. Yes. And if I'm to talk about raw food in Abuja, I think is almost the same thing whether you are living in the, you know, the rich side area or you are living at the other side of Abuja. I don't want to call it the poor area. Yeah, so when it comes to raw food, it's kind of equal. Yeah, it is. But when it comes to cooked food, restaurants and some other stuff, I will tell you that food in Abuja are expensive, because just on a seat you can be spending, just for yourself, you can be spending like 9,000 naira. If you are to go with a friend, be expecting, like, there's some restaurant that if two people are just eating in that restaurant, you'll be spending nothing less than 20,000 naira. And there's some restaurant that, okay, you guys must have seen those videos where I went with my friends, four of my friends, and we ate four plates of food, which was for like 26,000 naira and some other stuff like that. So when it comes to cooked food, I will tell you that food in Abuja are expensive, but when it comes to raw food, they are kind of affordable and they are equal. And I know of friends that lives here in Abuja that they don't buy their foodstuffs here because they feel like raw food in Abuja is expensive, so they will always order for food from another city, then they bring it down to Abuja to come and eat. I'm talking about raw foods now. So that is that about food in Abuja. So it depends on where you want to eat. If you are the type that enjoys street food, well, I can tell you that it is affordable, it's cheap. But if you're the type that love classic things like me, you want to eat in the best restaurant, you want to eat under AC, you don't want any heat at all, just be expecting to spend more money. Now, let me talk about life generally in Abuja. I will say that life generally in Abuja is stress-free. Yes, how do I mean? When it comes to transportation, when it comes to the drivers, when it comes to, you know, moving from one place to another, I will tell you categorically that Abuja is stress-free. Even the traffic in this city is nowhere to be compared with any other city in Nigeria because of the good road, you know. They have the good road and the drivers are always careful. And yeah, no matter what, even if rain falls or something, you'll still find your way to your house anytime, anywhere, any day. So I can tell you that life in Abuja is stressless. If you have good money, I can tell you, I can advise you to relocate to Abuja. And I will say this, you can get employment and some other good stuff here in Abuja. Like, life in Abuja is just beautiful. It's just lovely, especially if you have good money. I mean, it's good money. You will enjoy a very stressless life in Abuja, which I feel like it will expand your lifespan. But to live for like 60 years in Lagos, and if you find yourself in Abuja, it can be extended to like 70 to 80 years. So what am I trying to say? Life in Abuja is stressless, like it's stressless with money. Okay, thank you so much guys for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoy it. If you do, please like, share and subscribe if you are new. I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.